Hello students, how are you all? I'm your computer science teacher Chaitra. So in this chapter we are continuing with the types of computer hardwares. Hope you are aware of what is computer hardware. So can you just see in the image some of the hardware devices are there here. So what is a computer hardware? I have divided into this chapter into two parts, that is the part A and the part B. So what we are going to learn in part A is the hardware and the software inside the CPU cabinet. Hope everyone is aware of what is central processing unit. It's a brain of computer where it controls all the activities of the computer. Then what is motherboard, then what is RAM, microprocessor, hard disk, SMPS, graphic card and system fan. So in part A we are going to learn all these concepts. In part B we are going to learn about the modem, heat sink, bus cables, important computer ports. You can just see in the image I have given some ports here. So these are the ports. What are all the important computer ports are there? Then we are going to learn about modem, what is heat sink, what is bus cables, and then the exercise behind your textbook. So shall we start now? So we are doing with the chapter 3, that is the computer hardware. So computer is a programmable machine which performs arithmetic and logical operations. You know that. What is a computer? It's a programmable machine which performs arithmetic and logical operations. So what is arithmetic operations? Like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Then what is logical? It is nothing but the comparisons between the two numbers. Then computer is divided into two parts. For the mainly working of computer, we require the hardware devices and the software devices. You can just see the computer hardware here and this is the software. So you can just tell me the difference between what is hardware and what is software. So system software and the application software. Here some of the hardware devices are there, that is your monitor, mouse, keyboard, then speakers, then CPU, then you have VGA card, hard disk, everything, DVD, ROM, drive, power supply, everything. These are hardware devices. So for a computer to run, it requires both hardware devices as well as software devices. So software is required mainly for the working of the computer, and hardware devices controls the working of the computer. Next. Components that can be seen and touched are nothing but the computer hardware. Example, mouse, keyboard, speakers, hard disk, etc. So collection of physical components which form a computer system. So all this collection of physical components, so which can be seen and touched. You can touch all these things, correct? So you have a monitor, you can touch and see monitor how it looks. If you have a keyboard, you can touch and see the keyboard how it looks. Then if you have a mouse, speaker, then ROM, then CPU, inside CPU, then hard disk, everything can be touched and seen. So they are nothing but the hardware. So for example, web camera is there, mouse, keyboard, monitor and UPS. So these are some of the hardware which can be seen and touched. Next, what is a software? Let us see what is a software. A software is nothing but a set of programs that includes or a set of instructions or a data that enables computer to perform a particular task. Yes, we want a particular task. So our monitor, our mouse, everything is hardware device. So you can't you tell computer to monitor to do this. They are the hardware devices. So we need a software. Software is nothing but a set of instructions given to the computer to perform a particular task. There are two types of software. Normally software is divided into two types, that is your application software and the system software. So application software, you can just see here, nice image is there. So what are the application software? Like spreadsheets, computer games, word processor, database, internet browsers. So all these are application software. So what is system software? That is operating system and the utilities. So it helps, it connects between the hardware and the application software. So without operating system, the computer does not work. So it requires hardware as well as application software so that the user can work with it. So you can just see here in the image I have given what difference between the system software and the application software. So these are some of the system software which consists of our operating system, that is Windows, Linux, Unix, and application software complies of Office, MS Office, that is your Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Access, everything. So you can just find out the difference between the application software and the system software. System software is the software required for the system to run, and this software is required for the application to run. So both constitutes the software, so which is required for the computer to run. So this is hardware and this is the software. Next, so let us go inside the CPU cabinet. So what is there inside the CPU cabinet? You know, we have seen some CPU is nothing but central processing unit which processes the input and gives us the output. So let us see what is there inside the CPU cabinet. We have a system fan here, then a floppy drive, then heat sink, then hard drive, optical drive, then RAM module, processors, that is microprocessors, and the motherboard. You can just see the image of the motherboard, and main thing is power supply to the CPU. So if you have a CPU, you can just open it and you can see all these devices inside the CPU. CPU is a hardware within the computer that carries out the instruction of a computer program by performing basic arithmetic, logical input and output operations. CPU is a hardware within the computer that carries out instructions of a computer program by performing basic arithmetic, that is your addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, then logical, that is comparisons, and input or output operations. CPU is the main processing center which makes the system run. You have to note down this point. CPU is the main processing center. CPU acts as a main processing center which helps the system to run. The main components are motherboard. You can just see the motherboard image. Then RAM. What is RAM? Then you have a hard disk and SMPS, heatsink, and microprocessor. Random access memory is nothing but the RAM, and ROM is read-only memory. So RAM will be there inside the CPU. Next, let us see about motherboard. So how the motherboard looks. So you can just see the image how the motherboard looks. So it is the main circuit board, also known as logic board or the main board. It is also called as logic board. Each motherboard has a collection of chips, that is microchips, that is already you have studied in the generations, and controllers called as chipset. It has chips, microchips and controllers, both will form a chipset. It contains expansional slots for additional devices. So it has some slots for the additional devices. Other than four parts of the computer, it has some other slots for also the other devices. Now let us come to what is RAM. RAM is nothing but random access memory. It is the primary storage device. So when we are going to learn about the storage devices, we learn about RAM and ROM. So primary and secondary memory. So for primary is comprised of two things, that is RAM and the ROM. So RAM allows stored data to access directly in any random order, associates with the volatile types of memory. So what is a volatile data? Volatile data is a data that is lost when the computer is turned off or it is directly switched off. So if you have not saved the data will go. So please, you have to save the data once your work is done, because random access memory allows the stored data to access the memory directly. So it does not keep any other things, it directly allocates the memory location. So once you have done your work, please save it. If you have not saved, or suddenly when the computer is turned off or power will go, the automatically the data, whatever it's there in that memory, will go. So two types of RAM is DRAM, dynamic random access memory, static random access memory. So what is dynamic? The allocation is done dynamically. What is static? The names are given and the data will go and sit in that particular memory location. So nice example I can give you is your classroom. So dynamic allocation is you can go and sit wherever you want. That is static is you have to sit in the particular place. So wherever the place has been assigned. So SRAM is faster compared to DRAM. So why it is faster? Because you know your locations. So whenever you go and sit in your locations, it will be easy for the CPU to access the data. So if you go and sit somewhere and all, we can't recognize where the data is. So it is more faster compared to DRAM. DRAM need to be refreshed many times. SRAM need not be refreshed. So whenever the places are given, we know that it's you. Correct. So when we are allotted the space to you, we know that is you only sitting in that place. If someone comes, if you go and sit somewhere else, so we need to search for you. Correct. So in the classroom, we need to search for the people where it is. So the same thing happens inside the computer memory also. Whenever we give two data, that is 4 and 2 numbers, if it goes and sits somewhere else, so wherever it's not allocated, then it will be difficult for the CPU to get that data. Instead, if the slots are given, so you please go and sit in that place only, then the computer can fetch the data easily. Getting? So what is DRAM and what is dynamic and what is static? Next, let us talk about the microprocessor. Now microprocessor, hope everyone has heard the name microprocessor. It's an electronic component which is the brain of the computer. As we have seen that computer CPU is the brain of the computer. Inside the CPU there is one component, that is microprocessor, which is the brain of computer. It incorporates the function of CPU on a single integrated circuits. It incorporates the function of CPU, so all the functions of CPU is there in the single chip, that is microprocessor integrated circuit. It is a multi-purpose programmable device that accepts the digital data as input and process and then provides the output. So it accepts the digital data and as input and process it and then provides the output. So which is the brain of computer? Now the electronic component, that is the microprocessor. We have seen brain of computer is CPU. Inside CPU, which is microprocessor, is a very important electronic device. So next we'll see what is a hard disk. So hard disk is a storage device used for storing or retrieving data. We can just store the data or we can just retrieve the data or get the data. It is also called as secondary storage device, which is permanent, holds more data and faster than CDs. So it will be inside the CPU, which is permanent, and you can just save it in the hard disk. So it will be there. So it won't get, once the data is saved in the hard disk, so it will be there permanently. If suddenly the power goes off, then the data won't get erased. So it is more faster than the CDs. Next, SMPS. Switched mode power supply. SMPS is an electronic power supply. It supplies required power supply to all the components. Inside the CPU. Higher power conversion is an important advantage of SMPS. Higher power conversion. So SMPS, the switch mode power supply, is an electronic power supply that incorporates the switching regulator to convert the electric power efficiently. Like other power supplies, an SMPS transfers power from the source, like main power, to the load. Yes, this is nothing but when we are going to on the computer, who will give us the electricity? So that is given by the SMPS. So it's a switching regulator to convert the electrical power, what we get from the main board. Like power supplies, SMPS transfers the power from the source, like mains. Yes, it transfers it. It is there inside the CPU and it gives power to all the other devices which are there inside the CPU. Next, let us see what is a graphics card. Yeah, it is an expansion card that allows the computer to send the graphical information to video display devices such as monitor, TV or projector. It's an expansion card. It looks like this. So it allows the computer to send the graphical information to the video display devices. VDD, that is video display devices, are nothing but monitor, TV, projector, etc. They are the video display devices where video is going to be displayed. So this is an expansion card. Then you also find the graphics card inside the CPU. Then let us see what is a system fan. It removes excessive heat from the computer system, a thermal management cooling system. Yes, CPU gets heated up. You know what are all the problems it arises? All the devices may get damaged. So there should be some fan to remove the excessive heat whenever the computer is run for the long hours. So system fan, it removes the excessive heat from the computer system. So it's found on the left side panel and the back panel of the system unit. It directs the flow of air in the system unit. It cools down the CPU so that all the devices can be can run easily. So if you have a CPU, I just want everyone to just open the CPU and see these devices. So I've given a small activity here. I have given you some components and pictures. They have given you hard disk. You should give anyone advantage of the hard disk. Why hard disk is used? What is the advantage of using the hard disk? Then what is the advantages of SMPS? Is SMPS required? Then what is the advantage of microprocessor? And what is the advantages of RAM? So why we use this microprocessor? And what is the advantages of RAM? Next, give any 5 examples for hardware and software. So you have to give me 5 names of hardware and 5 names of software. So thank you. Be safe and healthy. Let us continue with the part B. Some more parts, internal parts inside the CPU in the part B. Thank you.